Hi, this is Gary with MacMOST.com. Here are some tips to help you make your MacBook last longer. MacMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MacMOST.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So let's say you just got a new MacBook and you want to make the MacBook last as long as possible. To really increase its longevity, you need to start good habits right now, so you don't have problems later on. Now my first tip is the only one I'm going to mention that you need to do before you buy your new MacBook. That's to get a large enough drive inside the MacBook. This is probably the most common problem I hear as to why people need to get a new MacBook, why they can't keep using their current one. It's that they got too small of an internal drive. Maybe they've got a 256 gig drive. Maybe that was fine for a while, but now they're taking more photos. Maybe they're editing 4K video. Whatever it is they're doing, the 256 gig drive is no longer big enough and they just have to get a new MacBook even though they hoped the current one would last a few more years. Okay, my next one seems to me to be the most obvious, but I still see tons of people using MacBooks without any kind of cover or case or protection at all. I've got a really simple plastic cover. It's just a thin shell. It doesn't increase the size of the MacBook much at all. But it does provide a lot of protection, especially for things like scratches, for taking impacts a little bit better. It's just much better to have a case like this on it. I never spend more than $20 on one of these cases, and as it kind of wears down after a couple of years, I'll just get a new one. But boy, when I take this case off, it's amazing to see the aluminum here look pristine. No scratches, scuff marks, nothing on it. Alternatively, you could get a sleeve. A sleeve you wouldn't have on while you're using the MacBook. You would slip it into it to then put it into your backpack or carry it somewhere. You have to have a lot of discipline to go with a sleeve instead of a case because you have to constantly be putting it on and taking it off. Now the third item goes with this, and that is handle with care. Now of course you're going to handle your MacBook with care, but even people that think they're taking good care of their MacBooks sometimes will find themselves tossing it into a backpack and then tossing that backpack into the back of a car. Doing that once, no big deal, but doing it day after day, year after year, will add wear and tear. While the aluminum makes it feel like it's just really solid, you still need to be careful with it. You're just getting into the habit of treating it with care in all cases, gently putting it in a backpack, treating your backpack with care when you know your MacBook is in it, will add up over the years and make your MacBook last. Now let's talk about batteries. I think the number one thing is that if you really want to have your MacBook last past 5 years, plan on getting a new battery. It's just chemicals in there that are worn down over time. If you want to have a MacBook last beyond 5 years, plan on the fact that at some point in the middle you're going to need a new battery. It's like a car. You can take perfect care of a car. At some point you're still going to need to get new tires. Now besides that, another thing you could do to care for the battery is to not use it needlessly. Now I'm a big advocate of using your MacBook, not letting it use you. So if you have to use it somewhere where there's no power, certainly use the battery. But if you're sitting at your desk or there's power right there, then use it on power. Don't follow some bad advice like actually using your MacBook battery when you could just have it easily plugged in. The fewer battery cycles, the better. So use it plugged in when it's convenient and use the battery when it's not convenient. But another big factor for battery use and for the entire machine is temperature. Try to keep your MacBook away from extreme temperatures. Don't let it get too hot. Don't let it get too cold. Mostly too hot though. So try not to leave it in a hot car. That's going to wear down particularly the battery. If you don't have air conditioning at home during the summer, try to use it in a cool room if possible, or at least store it in a relatively cool room. Another handle with care kind of issue is opening and closing your MacBook. When you do that, you're just using these mechanical hinges that are in here. Now in the past, Apple's had trouble with these hinges. There's really been no problems with the current aluminum MacBooks. But every new model that comes out, it's slightly different. So I try not to take any risks, which means that when I open my MacBook, I really think about it. I open it up nice and smoothly. I don't jerk it open. And when I go to close it, I don't slam it down. Again, this is the kind of thing that works with repetition. Accidentally slamming it down once or opening it too quickly once is no big deal. It's how you deal with your MacBook every day, day in, day out, trying to make it last 5, 7, 9 or more years. And the same thing for the ports. When you plug into a port or pull a connection out, do it gently. Because in the past, these ports here, which again are just physical objects, right? And every time you push it in, you're actually applying force. They can break. And it's not uncommon for somebody to have a perfectly good MacBook that works really well, except that one of the ports now isn't working. It really pays just to get into the habit of carefully and gently inserting a connector and then carefully and gently pulling it out. It'll also make the actual cables last longer. Also, treat your power adapters with care and the cables too. Now, fortunately today, these are all replaceable. You can get another power adapter. You can even get smaller, lighter ones from other companies. And also these cables, they can be easily replaced. Maybe $10 and you can get a new power cable. But still, if you are using your MacBook for a long time, it would be nice to keep using the originals. So treat these with care. You know, make sure they're kind of kept clean. When you need to wrap the cable around it, don't wrap it super tight. Maybe just fold the cable up and put a Velcro strap or something on it. If you care for this, this should last you the whole life of your MacBook. All right, so now a word about keyboard covers. Little things like this that you could put over the keyboard and it keeps the keyboard clean. That seems like a really good idea and something that should extend the life of your MacBook. The only problem is that when you add one of these to the keyboard and when you close the screen, you may be putting pressure against the screen and against the keyboard. Definitely do not close your MacBook with one of these in there. If you want to use one, you have to put it on and take it off every time you open and close your MacBook. There are plenty of reports online for people with broken screens or broken keyboards because they used one of these. But you definitely do want to keep your keyboard clean. The best way to do that is simply not to get it dirty in the first place. Maybe practice washing your hands before using the keyboard, especially if you're working in some sort of industry where your hands get dirty often. Like you're an auto mechanic and then you go to use your MacBook, maybe plan on only doing that when you have clean hands instead of constantly getting dirt on it and then having to actually clean it, which could also then wear things down. All those things, anytime you're doing something with the keyboard like that, you risk maybe getting some dirt in there or maybe pressing a key too hard or breaking something. So you want to have good habits and minimize how often you get your keyboard dirty and thus how often you have to clean it. Now from a software standpoint, the main thing you want to do is be a minimalist. Don't throw a lot of junk on your MacBook. Most of the time when somebody complains that their Mac is slow, it's because they've just overloaded it with stuff that's running in the background. Think about it this way. Every time you put new software on your Mac, you're making your Mac more complex. There's more on it that's running, more that's going on. And every time you make it more complex, you're adding more points of failure, more things that could be slowing it down or causing trouble. To minimize that, only install things that you really truly need. And that brings me to my next point, which may be the biggest thing out of all of this, which is don't put up with problems. Your Mac is running slow. If something isn't working, I so often hear from people saying that for the last year or the last 6 months, my Mac's been running slow. Do you have any idea what could be wrong? If something's wrong with your Mac, you have free technical support from Apple. Call them or take it to the Genius Bar and they'll take a look at it and be able to fix the problem for you. It's probably something that you installed that isn't working well with your operating system or with some other software. But the important thing is don't put up with issues like that. If your Mac is running slow or having problems and you can't fix it yourself, get help from Apple or another expert. And one more thing I need to mention here is that if you want your MacBook to last a long time, you have to make sure nobody steals it. It's easy to steal a MacBook. We carry them around everywhere. You have to get in the habit of always knowing where your MacBook is, remembering that this thing is worth a lot and that somebody may try to steal it. I know this seems obvious, but you have to kind of practice it every day. There is no substitute for just being aware of where your MacBook is at all times and making sure that somebody can't easily steal it. So while I'm sure most people were practicing some or most of these things already, hopefully this video gave you some new ideas about how to make your MacBook last as long as possible. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.